Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. Just before 10 a.m. at 9:52 a.m. local time there in South Dakota, we had a magnitude 3.4 earthquake. So far, 31 people reported feeling this earthquake. This area is quite interesting for its location because back eons ago when the continents were moving around, plates collided, building mountains all the way up to Wyoming. And that formed what's called the Wyoming Crater, which is now the North American Crater. You can see how it extends all the way up to Canada. And what do we have up north of this location? Yep, the Yellowstone Supervolcano. Using Google Earth, here we have the Black Hills. Those were formed by the continents, the tectonic movement of the plates. This is the location of that 3.5 earthquake. Over here we have the Badlands, which is basically filled in from sediment, from eons of erosion of these mountains. The Wyoming Crater is initially the core for the North American Crater. And it gets more confusing if you look at all the different plates that were moving around, sliding around as the Earth was created. The Black Hills is also part, as it's called, the Archean Wyoming Crater. I'll give you two links to two different research papers about the mountain building of the tectonic plates that occurred in this area. And it shows stress is building. If I'm right, then we'll probably have some more earthquakes further north. So I thought I'd look at some of the earthquakes that are occurring there. Here we got Maple Creek, Wyoming. And this is the Little West Thumb, one of the latest cratons, I guess you can call it, there at Yellowstone Lake. Here's another image of the Wyoming Craton, and you can see we got the Black Hills here, Rapid City. This is right along the edge where we had that magnitude 3.4 earthquake. In other reports, I've talked about how failed rift systems have become more active. And there's been a lot of interplate earthquakes lately. And those occur because of the pressure of the continents moving. Most recently, I can think about the earthquake they had there in New York, the state of New York. That's because the plate out there in the Atlantic Ocean is trying to push the United States there west. Anyways, here's a map of felt reports from that 3.4 earthquake. We have to actually click on it to see. Here we got Edgemont, 9 reports from there. Another 2 from Edgemont. Hot Springs had 1. Another location in Hot Springs, 7. 1 Hot Springs, 3 from that location. Custer, there was 1 from there, and another one from Custer. Yeah, back in 2007, there was a magnitude 3.1 there on the edge of the Badlands. Yeah, we don't get earthquakes here very often, but it's been kicking in a little bit more of late. December 9th of last year, 2020, there was a magnitude 3.2 earthquake near Bottle, South Dakota. Yep, the continents are still moving and they seem to have kicked in. Let me bring this out so you can see how close it is to Yellowstone Supervolcano, right there. That's all. The black line is uplift from the volcano, and I drew out the red lines as a diameter, and we'll come back over here. Here's that 3.5. Yeah, so more than likely we're going to have a large earthquake coming from the location of Yellowstone. So did you feel this 3.5 earthquake? How long did it last? What direction did it feel like it came from? Did you hear it before you felt it? Did you have any damage? You very possibly could have hairline cracks in your foundation if you're close enough. You can see the mountain range here. Did anything fall from the shelves? Were you sleeping, sitting, etc.? Please put all that information down below. Thank you for watching. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.